Hey YouTube, and welcome back to Under Fire Reviews. As always, I'm your host, Zachary Pickett, and this week, I'm reviewing something I have been waiting for, personally, for a long, long, long time. That is the first official album from the artist of the Weeknd called Kiss Land. For those of you who are already fans of the Weeknd like myself, may be thinking, well, does this album stack up to the mixtapes Thursday, House of Balloons, or even Echoes of Silence, or even the beautifully remastered trilogy? And I have to say, yeah, it does. This album did not leave me crying in a shallow pool of my own tears. Starting off, the album does not feel like a traditional album would, meaning that it feels like one giant song strung together. There were multiple times when I was marathoning the album that each song flowed into the next song, and I was like, okay, it's time to change the track, but this song's running on a little bit too long, and I realized, wow, I'm on like the fifth track. It has a beautiful, beautiful sense of flow and something that I haven't seen in a while, and I'm really hoping I see again soon. It also keeps the standard dark R&B that we're used to hearing from The Weeknd. Instead of songs appealing to love and getting intimate with a partner in a more romantic way, The Weeknd style is still present. It's still very, very raw, very, very, I guess, dirty in a sense. But then again, I do like that I need a shower feeling after I listen to the song sometimes, and him choosing to stick to this style shows that he's committed to being consistent in his work, which is something I can truly admire. And also, his vocal talent is still present in this album. He still displays that wonderful falsetto with the voice that's never really forced with the melody, but rides along with it, creates something beautiful. Also, I will have to state that this album does kind of lack the musical punch that the other three mixtapes have, because I guess for those who are accustomed to the Weeknd style, the mystery is gone, really. There's not really that huge feeling of, wow, this music is straight hitting me in the face. But I do think it's an enjoyable experience, even though at times the album does kind of dwell within its own melodrama based on its subject matter. And although it may seem like I'm lauding praise on the album is not without flaws. For one thing, the track Live For, the chorus is absolutely awful. I don't know why I can't stand it, but I can't. And as I stated previously, the album does kind of bask in its own melodrama. But I will say on the inverse that the album has a very unique variation of styles, I guess. Meaning that it can swap from that slow brooding sound as seen in something like Adaptation into something very high energy like Wanderlust. And it's this constant up and down roller coaster that the album gives that I think makes it something truly a sight to behold. In conclusion, this album gets a 4 out of 10 for me. It is absolutely amazing. I think it's something every Weeknd fan should pick up. And for those who haven't been introduced to The Weeknd yet, I think this is probably the best starting point you can get before you get into the older and what I think at times is better stuff. So as always, I'll leave a link in the description below to the Vevo channel where you can see these wonderfully weird music videos that come with these songs, and a link to Amazon where you can purchase the album. But as always, thank you all for watching. If you've liked what you heard, leave a like, comment, or subscribe. And I'll see you next week with yet another review. But for now, kick back and experience a little more of The Weeknd. There are certain things that I've come to understand. Expectations can kill a simple man, a simple man.